हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट ट्रैक्टर बैटरी एंड हाउ फ्रीक्वेंटली क्वेश्चन हैज बीन आस्क्ड अबाउट बैटरी चार्जिंग एंड डिस्चार्जिंग। सो द वर्ल्ड इज टुडे मूविंग टुवर्ड्स द इलेक्ट्रिक व्हीकल एंड लिथियम आयन बैटरी इज वेरी प्रीशियस। सो वन क्वेश्चन अबाउट लिथियम आयन बैटरी एंड वी विल डिस्कस द आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन एट द एंड ऑफ द वीडियो। सो द क्वेश्चन इज द कंसिडर फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स फॉर द लिथियम आयन बैटरी, वाई इट इज नॉट वाइडली यूज इन ट्रैक्टर्स। So, even though lithium-ion battery is used widely in electric vehicles, but it is not widely used in tractors. So, there are two statements. First one is, it produces less power. Second one, it affects highly while working in the higher temperature. So, which one of these two statements is the correct statement we have to choose? We will find this answer at the end of the video. So, these are some outlets. Join us on these channels. So, guys, battery. We know that battery stores the electricity. So the main purpose of the battery is to provide the electricity for the operating and the starting of the motor self-starter. So our tractors are not driven like rickshaw to have an handle and we will pull it to get started. It has electric auto starting system. So the self-motor starter is driven by battery. Then it supplies energy to other instruments of tractor which are electrically operated, like headlights, lamps, night lamps, then other any equipment which works on track electricity, like charging point. So the to supply the energy and to provide a starting of the tractor, these are two main major purposes of the battery. In tractor, battery employs lead and sulfuric acid. So the battery used in the tractor is called as lead acid battery. Lead and sulfuric acid both having cathodic and anodic properties. So guys, here one question for you. Comment below in comment section that which one is anode and which one is cathode in the lead acid battery. So each battery consists of number of cells, as the voltage of each cell when fully charged is slightly more than 2 volts. And 6 cells are required for 12 volt of battery. One thing I have to discuss here. The batteries are available in 6 volt, 12 volt and 24 volt category. But the 12 volt category battery is widely used in tractors. So the battery is meant for storing of electricity in chemical form. While a tractor is running normally, the battery is automatically charged by means of its charging system. So alternator is used to charge the battery. It is very important point. I have not written here. The alternator is used to charge the battery, which converts the mechanical energy into electric energy and transforms to it battery. The electric energy is converted into chemical energy while the plates of the battery are being charged. And when the battery is being discharged, the energy stored in chemicals is released as electricity. So when we apply electric flux, the flow from the battery towards the equipments will continues. Then the battery is said to be the discharge when it has no large longer capable of releasing electricity at usable voltage. So even though the battery having some low voltage, if it is not workable or it is not functionable, then battery is said to be discharged. The tractor is provided with 12 volt, 18 ampere or 88 ampere maintenance free batteries. So guys, as I have earlier said, the 12 volts batteries are used in tractors. The negative terminal is earthen and the battery is connected in series. We will see the construction of the battery. So these are 6 cells. Here we will see the cells are connected in series with each other. These are 6 cells, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Every cell is of 2 volt, so total 6 multiplied by 2, the battery is of 12 volts. These are lead plates, whereas the sulfuric acid will be filled here. We have to maintain the level of acid in the battery to mark the proper functioning of the battery. So to check the battery level, one port is given above the battery. So we will frequently see the acid level in the battery. If we are working we are in the working condition and we find that the battery is not working properly even though it is in charging position. So it might be due to the less acid level or acidic water level in the battery. So we have to remove the cap, then we have to fill water in the battery so as to normalize the level of acidic battery. So sulfuric acid, which is H2SO4, is used here as acid, and lead is provided with plates. The battery is constructed in such a manner that each cell contains positive and negative plates alternately. You will see the alternate positive and negative plates are connected. Then each negative plate is separated from positive plate by non-conducting porous separator, which is prevents plates from touching each other. If these plates come in contact, then there will be a short circuit or the battery will lose its functioning. So there are some porous material filled, which is insulating material, inside these plates so as to that battery plates remain untouched with each other. Then all the positive plates are joined together to a post strap and forming a positive group. All the negative plates are joined together to similar post strap forming negative group. So you will find here the positive terminals are attached to a single place and the negative similar way as are going to be attached to form two terminals of positive and negative terminal to complete the structure. So this was about the construction of battery. Here the point is to maintain the water level or sulfuric acid level to have the good functioning. Then the question has been asked, how we will know the battery is charged or uncharged? So there is one test which is called as specific gravity test. What is specific gravity? Can anyone define? Just comment below in comment section what is specific gravity. So to check the battery charging, we have to conduct the specific gravity electrolyte to the battery. In modern batteries, some indicators are provided here, which are red and green in nature. So we can assume if a red light is going on, so battery is in working position. But if these are not provided, we have to find the charging position of the battery with specific gravity. So this is an instrument. Can anyone name which instrument it is? So the specific gravity is measured with hydrometer, and it is an hydrometer which conduct in the specific gravity test. So these are some conditions, and these are frequently asked question in GRF and CET exams, when the battery is charged, when specific gravity is --, or when the specific gravity is this one, then how much the battery is charged. So when battery is fully charged, the specific gravity is 1.22 to 1.25. It is half charged, then 1.210. When it is discharged, it might have less than or equal to 1.150 specific gravity. See here, specific gravity don't have any unit, so it is just a numerical value. For initial filling of the electrolyte, we should have specific gravity of 1.300. So these were some conditions at which the specific gravity is checked and the charging position of battery is to be decided. So the frequently or precisely it is called a specific gravity test. To check the specific gravity of battery with hydrometer. With a float, it will be conducted like with the float in the vertical position away from the side of the barrel. So take the reading at the eye at the level of the bottom of the curve position of the liquid. So here how hydrometer should be used, written here. The specific gravity should not vary more than 0.025 points from cell to cell. So we have to check the specific gravity of each cell. As earlier I have said, there are 6 cells. So we should carry specific gravity test for all 6 cells. So we will get some points, some values of 1, 2, 3, 4. And we have to average them to take whole specific gravity of the battery. If the specific gravity is below 1.25, charge the battery and inspect the charging system to determine the cause of the low battery charge. So why it is low battery charge, we should find out. Is it reducing acidic level or having some plate damages? We have to find out with this charging test. So specific gravity test is conducted for determining charging of battery. So we will back to our question. So statements were there, it produces less power and it affects highly while working in temperature. So guys, lithium ion battery is used in electric vehicles. Here the option is second, only two is correct, because it never produces less power. It produces higher power or equal power as usual to lead acidic battery, but it affects highly while working in high temperature. We know we use tractor in very heat areas or in whole day working condition. So while affecting with highly temperature, it reduces its efficiency. That's why the lithium ion batteries are not widely used in tractors. So option 2 is correct. This was today's video. Thanks, and join us on our this channels. Thank you.